the gateway that I want you to open is just the ability to understand that not all humans are different, but what makes us unique and special is how we connect with each other and find the human grounds of our interconnections.
What's up, GRIO family? My name is Stephen London, director of video here at thegrio.com. And today I'm joined by the beautiful Leyna Bloom, actress, model, and activist. Hey, Leyna.
Hi. How's it going, guys? I'm happy to be here. It's such a beautiful day. So I'm excited to have some beautiful conversation.
Yes. And speaking of beautiful conversation, what about a beautiful masterpiece that you are featured in? Port Authority. Tell me all about this film. There are so many milestones that were reached with you being in this film. First trans woman of color, first trans woman period to even be in a leading film at this big, huge film festival that's been going on for years. It's almost kind of like a bittersweet, right? I can imagine it's like, here I am, the first, but why did it take so long?
Well, this movie, the sense of this movie is about love. It's about two different worlds just coming together. It's a very, very unique depiction of something that is very raw and just really honest about New York City and how we live here and how the most unique experiences are just around every single corner. And this movie really is very different. I mean, it's a beautiful movie, but there's some very raw, dark, gritty edginess about the film that really just really provokes this anticipation of like what indie films are about.
Yeah.
It's not supposed to be perfect. It's not supposed to be beautiful. It's not a huge multi-million dollar project. It's literally bringing elements of like what's honest and not honest in society and just really reframing it in a way that is literally for the artistic mind to explore in infinity like layers. So I'm just really profound by the ability to create a piece of art and have it be so many different emotions into one. I didn't do this film because the story is rich in its tell. I did this story because there is this honest rawness about the intersections of our environment coming together and the duality of that being transfixed amongst this new generation of people that think differently, that see differently, that view themselves differently.
But in the trailer, there's a scene of the main character who is almost saying like, maybe I don't want to, I don't want people to see me for something that I am not, right? Like I don't want to be mislabeled. However, at the core, we're seeing that these two people are falling in love, essentially. What was that moment like for you watching the film back and knowing of so many of these stories and in real life? How was that watching that back?
For that particular scene, for example, when he was saying, I don't want people knowing who I am. I think I was like, the character was saying like, are you listening to yourself? You don't want people to know who you are, but do you even know who you are? Do you even know what you're attracted to? Do you even know what this energy is? Do you even know how special a connection is? Did you feel anything?
Right.
You know, like we're so like neglecting the conscious of how our spiritual connection is to other people that we only put labels on it because it is in our conscience to understand that happiness is not attainable and these type of connections is not valued in society as beautiful. So I think it's just, it takes a moment to like really pause for a second to really understand how special a human connection can be, especially for a Black and Brown spiritual being in spaces in society that is very fragile and gentle to our experiences with unfamiliarity.
What do you want for people to feel or learn after watching this film? If there was one thing that you're like, as an actress, as someone that got to be in this film, what is the one takeaway that you wish people nail down when they leave that theater?
I want to see how beautifully complex these characters are. I want you to really pay attention to how you resonate with that, because it's really just mirroring you. You know what I mean? Like how beautiful complexities are and how beautiful storytelling is and how it doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to be. Is it existing? And it's just an idea. It's like a painting. You go into a museum, you're not familiar with this type of style of art, but it's something that's reaching and speaking to you. And the more that you really are coherent in that energy, the more you open a new gateway to your mind. And the gateway that I want you to open is just the ability to understand that not all humans are different, but what makes us unique and special is how we connect with each other and find the human grounds of our interconnections.
And I want to use that word right there, intersections and interconnections, as a segue to ask my next question. You are the first of so many, as we're seeing, you know, first women, trans women of color to be leading in this film. Now also first trans woman to be featured in Sports Illustrated. I mean, how amazing is that? Like, how does that make you feel?
It makes me feel very honored. You know, these are like, in America is a very new country. So any things that are triumph or on significance of historical events is really profound and new for a lot of people. I feel like if you go back into countries like Europe or other places in the world that has a long history of celebrations of different unique creativities, you can see a vast of long longevity with that. But with us, it's so new and profound that it's just honestly the last 5 years, we've been able to access opportunity to be able to be in history, and allows us to not just live for today, but allows us to live forever in history. So I just think it's just a new energy for me. Like, when I think of making history, I feel like I've been given the opportunity to be a princess, or to be seen as like somewhat of a Disney character in society, because we grew up knowing these stories of these, you know, Snow White and, you know, Sleeping Beauty and Pocahontas. That here's a story of Y, who is in some similarities navigating herself and her community, just like Pocahontas is. So I just think it's just this fragment of our imaginations that is really allowing us to explore things inside us that we were taught to suppress. So I think that's what this movie and what these moments mean, is just honestly live in our greatness and live in our beauty, and seize this opportunity as something that belongs to us, that should have belonged to us a long time ago. So I'm just honestly celebrating all the time that we have to reclaim.
I know you got the opportunity to be on Pose this season. How was that process like for you? And what does Pose mean to you? What was that experience like? And watching the show, what do you think that's doing for the culture?
I think it goes to what is rooted in why I wanted to do this. You know, why I wanted to be in ballroom, why I wanted to find people like myself, why I wanted to have the courage to go out and be my most authentic self. You know, when I got the opportunity to be in Pose, I looked at it from a point of view as like, you know, what does this mean for culture? You know what I mean? What does this mean for people that paved the way for me to be here? You know, and I'm constantly wrapped around my mind of like, you know, this is a moment that is going to be temporary, but what this allows is things is for us to live, you know, live forever. You know, 50 years from now, when I look back and we talk about that shift in culture, we talk about how the magic from the concrete started blooming, you know, we're going to be talking about Pose. We're going to talk about how entertainment took a chance, and that chance created opportunities for us to feed ourselves, to feed our communities. I think to be a part of that history is so profound. And I'm so lucky to have the opportunity to look beside me and behind so much of our rich culture being displayed. So for me, it's just the ability to just wake up, clock in, go into the hair and makeup chair, to put on a costume, to be able to be on set. That is an honor that my culture and the people in my culture have yearned for so many years,
yeah,
to just be seen. So it's truly a out of mind, body, spiritual experience that will be used as a form of education for the years to come as how to do it and what we have done to create something for ourselves, which is truly powerful.
And I'm so happy that I almost want to be like candid and just be like, about damn time, right? Like about damn time. We see moments in history that have been captured through media. Of course, the iconic Paris is Burning. We're seeing amazing films like Port Authority and now Pose. And shout out to Ryan Murphy and Janet Mock and just the entire incredible team. They're just fantastic. Steven, all of them, just a fantastic crew. But for me, it's like, yes, like this is exactly what we need. There's so many friends of mine, and particularly Black cis women, who are watching this and being like, oh, wow, I didn't know that it was like that. And so we constantly are asking our peers and our allies to do the work and to show up. And I think that Pose in some way is homework for a lot of the community. Is there anything that you particularly as a trans woman would like to see from Black cis women in this space or even Black cis men? I know that it is not our job to teach anybody, right, to do anything for us. But it is important that whenever we have a platform to say what's on our mind, I encourage that. So I want to give you that space now. Is there anything that you would want to see more from Black cis women or heterosexual men or whatever to support our community and your community in particular?
I think for me, I've never lived for the approval of anyone. You know, if you're watching and you don't really acknowledge my existence, that doesn't really give me, you know, anything. You know what I mean? Like, I'm living for my own approval. I'm not living for your eyelashship.
That's right.
For your broken promises. You know, I just honestly, I live here too. And the idea that I have to ask for you to want to see me, it's not going to happen. I see myself. Everything that I did was from my own hands and from my own heart, an inspiration to us all, not just a female figure. It's an inspiration to my own unique ability to be my authentic self. We are all the same in a lot of ways, but we are all different in a lot of ways. We have every right to be. So just like you want to be supported, I would like to do the same thing. But if you're not giving me the opportunity to be seen, then I can go somewhere else. And that's honestly what it comes down to. You know, we teach people to love each other by teaching ourselves how to love ourselves. You know, like, I can't sit here and expect you to love me if you don't love yourself, and vice versa. So the best advice I can give anyone is just to love yourself. And when you learn how to do that, then you'll understand how important it is to love each other.